Hello and welcome to Class 8 of Eashoa Yoga, Christ-Centered Yoga Practice. This class is entitled Holy Breath, Holy Spine. We're going to begin in a seated position with the legs crossed, sits bones pressing down into the floor, and the crown of the head reaching up high towards the heavens. Begin to observe your breath, the in-breath and the out-breath, as you open up to this practice. Feel the belly relax and the ribs expand and contract, the upper chest lifting and falling, the back shoulders filling and emptying. Breathe in and out with conscious awareness. Take time to notice the gift of your breath. Begin to layer your awareness with ujjayi breath, deepening your breath, deepening your focus, diving into this inner yoga experience. Feel the buoyancy of the heart and lungs as you fill and empty. Be aware of any feelings or qualities, any relationship you might have with your breath. As you sit in this subtle awareness, open your heart and your ears. Listen to this scripture from Ezekiel, a prophet of the Old Testament. Prophesy to these bones and say to them, dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. This is what the Sovereign Lord says to these bones. I will make breath enter you, and you will come to life. I will attach tendons to you and make flesh come upon you and cover you with skin. I will put breath in you, and you will come to life. Come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe into these bones that they may live. Allow this scripture to resonate in your bones. Feel the connection that you have with spirit. Breath is sometimes translated as wind or spirit. So as you breathe in and out and feel the breath move through the marrow of your bones, through the muscles and tendons and skin, feel the aliveness of your breath, the vibrancy and vitality of each inhalation and exhalation. Allow yourself to dive into the possibility that your breath is intricately bound and connected to the creative breath of God's Spirit. That every breath you take has been sent to you from on high. Receive the profound gift of your breath. Deepen even further into your ujjayi breath and place your hands on your belly. Feel the seat of your breath in your belly. Take your left hand, place it on your belly below your navel, and take your right hand behind you on your lower back. As you breathe in and out, feel the breath expand both to the front and to the back. Feel the in and out of both hands. Acknowledge your body as an indwelling place for the spirit. What goes in the body comes out. Breathing in, breathing out. Allow the left hand to travel above the navel, but below your ribs. And bring your right hand further up your back, so it's parallel to the left hand in front. Feel the breath in and out. Now bring both hands to the heart. Place the left palm over the heart and the right hand over the left hand. Visualizing another set of hands behind your heart supporting you, keeping you strong, filling you up. Breathe in and out from this heart space. And now, relax your hands on your lap and bring your attention to your spine. We will be going into a deep visualization for the spine. Use your breath here to bring you into focus. There are 5 vertebrae in the lumbar or lower spine. Become aware of the beginning of your spine, the tailbone, the sacrum protecting the spine. Get a sense of the tailbone softly reaching back and creating some space. Feel the breath go through the center of the spine. And now move up to the cervical spine. All the way up to the curve of the neck. The tip of the spine rests very deep in the head. The skull actually sets on top of the spine. As you bring your attention to the spine, bring your your attention to the space between each vertebrae, feeling the sponge-like opening supporting each vertebrae. And now draw your attention to the center of your spine, into the cerebral spinal fluid that moves up and down the core of the spine, the very core of your whole being. Holy spine, sacred spine, backing you up, supporting you, moving you through life. Feel the natural buoyancy and curves of your spine. Feel the breath flow up and down as you inhale, lengthen your spine, creating even more space between each vertebrae. As you exhale, let there be a softening, a releasing down, feeling the weight of the vertebrae supported on each sponge-like disc. The bottom of the spine is like a big rooted tree, a big mouth kind of wrapping itself around the lower body. Feel as if your spine was rooted down and has the fluidity and flexibility to move with the wind. As you meditate on your spine, open your heart and your ears to the following scripture. I am your God, who brought you up out of Egypt. Open wide your mouth, and I will fill it. You would be fed the finest of wheat. With honey from the rock, I would satisfy you. As you draw attention to your spine, imagine the cerebral spinal fluid being fed and nourished by this divine link. Open wide the mouth of your spine and draw in energy from the earth, from the heavens. Christ is in front of you. Christ is behind you. Christ is to the right of you. Christ is to the left of you. Christ is below you. Christ is above you. Christ is all around you. Christ is within you. Feel that light of Christ lighting up your spine and radiating out through the nerves, through the bones and muscles and organs. From your focus on the breath and the spine, we will be moving into a series of spinal movements to lubricate the joints, to lubricate the vertebrae, and to keep the fluid moving in the central channel of the spine. So you're in cross-legged position. Take your hands and slide them underneath your shins, moving the lower part of your spine Inhale, arch and press the belly forward. Exhale, tuck the tailbone and round. Do this a few times, mostly focusing on the lower back. So there's a slight arch and a slight hunch. Inhale forward and exhale back. Firmly grip your fingers around your shins and increase the movement now, coming into your thoracic spine, pressing the ribs forward as you inhale, rounding and releasing as you exhale. Forward and back. Forward and back. Adding the cervical spine, let the chest lift up and press forward. Slightly tilt the head back as you inhale. Exhale, round. So now the whole spine is activated, moving forward and back. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Allow the movement to move more quickly. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Strong inhalation, strong exhalation. Moving through, forward and back, forward and back. Now come forward and inhale and hold the breath in. Feel the movement of your spine echoing in your body. Hold until you need to release. And whatever that might be, just exhale, relax your hands on your lap, and take in a few breaths here. Good. Now slide your hands to your kneecaps. Let the palms rest very gently on your knees and come into spinal torso circles. Begin with a circle to the left, pressing the spine over to the left, bringing the chest forward, and then to the right and back. So as if you were making a full circle with your torso. The breath is in as you come forward, and the breath is out as you go back. Breathing in, breathing out. And just like in your spinal flexes, begin to increase the momentum. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Side forward, side back. Bring all your awareness to your spine and your breath. And now pause and reverse your circle. Right forward, left back, right forward, left back. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Continue. Inhale when you come back to center. Exhale, relax and release that movement. So far, we flexed the spine forward and back. And we've articulated the spine from side to side and forward and back. And now we're going to come into a rapid twist. Inhale, right. Exhale, left. Twist to the right. Twist to the left. Head turns to the right. Head turns to the left. Torso to right, torso to left. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Keep it going. Inhale to center, hold the elbows up. Hold to the edge of your strength, the edge of your breath. And exhale, relax, release the arms into your lap. And take in those three movements of the spine. Now come onto your hands and knees. hands under the shoulders, knees under the hips. Inhale, extend the tailbone back, sink the belly down, lift the chest forward and lift the throat and head up. Exhale, tuck the tailbone, round the spine, arching, roll the shoulders and chin down. Follow the curve of your spine, inhaling, extending, exhaling, rounding. Go with your breath, and in this movement, be aware of your vertebrae. Be aware of the space between your vertebrae. Inhaling and exhaling. Ujjayi breath on the inhale. Ujjayi breath on the exhale. Come back to table position and curl the toes. Lift the knees off the floor, walk the hands towards the toes. Come into a squat with the heels on the floor and your hands to your thighs. Lift the torso up about halfway. Tuck the tailbone under, exhale, round your spine. Inhale, arch and extend. Exhale, round. Inhale, extend. Exhale, round. Inhale, roll all the way up to standing. Feel your vertebrae, feel your spine. Relax and open up the sits bones. Release the feet down and step the feet a little bit wider than hip width apart. Allow the arms to come down to your sides. Take a breath in. Exhale, swing your arms to the right as you turn your torso to the right, coming up onto the ball of the left foot. Inhale to center. And exhale, twist to the left, letting the arms swing to the left, coming up to the ball of the right foot, and come down. So what you're doing is a swing from side to side. Inhale, center, exhale to the right. Inhale, center, exhale to the left. Arms are very loose. An effortless movement. Arms swing to the right. Torso and head turn to the right. Arms swing to the left. Torso and head swing to the left. Back and forth. Inhaling and exhaling. Bring yourself back to center and walk the feet underneath your hips. Come to mountain pose and relax your arms to your sides. Listen to the message of your spine. How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord God of hosts. My soul yearns, even faints, for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God. Feel that life force flowing through your spine. Feel the life force flowing through your breath. Bring your arms to your sides. Inhale, circle the arms up overhead. Look to your fingertips. Exhale, circle the arms down. Bring the palms together in front of the heart in prayer position. Bow your head towards your heart. Repeat this breath two more times. Circle the arms up. Inhale, look up towards the ceiling. Look to your fingertips. Exhale, circle the arms down and bring the palms together in front of the heart. Bow towards your heart. Last time, inhale, circle the arms up. Look towards your fingertips. Exhale, circle the arms down, bring the hands in a prayer position, and bow towards the heart. Take a moment to breathe here. settle deeply into Standing Mountain with hands in prayer pose. See your body as the sanctuary of the living God. Praise God in His sanctuary. Praise Him in His mighty heavens. Praise Him for His acts of power. Praise Him for His surpassing greatness. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Feel the wave of your breath as a celebration, a praise and thanksgiving. From Standing Mountain, we're going to move into a number of postures to work on the spine, to keep the spine flexible and alive, vibrant with the life force of the living God. Come to the front of your mat and bring your arms up overhead in Standing Mountain. Circle the arms down and bring the hands into a prayer position. Take another breath in. Now step out to the right. Turn the right foot straight ahead and take the left foot and turn it in about an inch towards the right foot. Open your arms into a wide T. Reach over the right leg. Allow the right arm to come down towards the right shin or the floor. And let the left arm extend up into Standing Triangle. Breathe in. Revolve the head to look towards the left hand. Anchor the back foot down. Bend the right knee and slide the right elbow to rest on top of the right thigh. Hug the left arm in close to the ear, left palm facing down. Parsvottanasana. Press into the back foot. Come up, paralleling the torso. Extend the left arm behind you and the right arm in front of you. The right knee is still bent. And now you're in Warrior Two, looking over the right fingertips. Press into the back foot and inhale, come up, and pivot to the left side. Take the left foot straight ahead, and the right foot turns in about an inch. Reach over the left leg, bringing the left arm down towards the floor or the left inner calf. Right arm extends up, lining up with the left arm. Look to your right fingertips if that's comfortable, in Trikonasana or Triangle Pose. Bend the left knee, sliding the left elbow to rest on top of the left thigh. Hug the right arm in over the right ear, right palm down, and revolve the head to look underneath the right arm. Take another breath in, press into the back foot, extend the right arm behind you and the left arm in front of you. Warrior Two, look over your left fingertips. Breathe in. Breathe out. Come back to standing. Pivot both feet so they're facing the same direction in a wide angle. Open the arms wide in a T. And now bring the hands down to your hips. Press down gently on the hips. Lengthen up through your wonderful spine. And exhale, come forward into wide angle forward bend. Prasrita Padottanasana. Fingertips come underneath the shoulders or use a block underneath your hands. If you would like to deepen this posture, come down onto the crown of the head, or grab hold of the big toes or the outside arches of the feet. Draw the crown down and lengthen, lifting the sits bones and the tailbone up. Feel the release of the head, neck, and spine. Bring your hands under your shoulders. And now take your hands to your hips, pressing firmly into the feet. Draw energy in and up through the spine as you inhale, come up. Step or jump the feet together. Inhale, circle the arms up, look to your fingertips. Exhale, circle the arms down and turn your feet sideways on your mat. Coming into downward dog, bend forward, bring the palms forward and step the feet back. Holding the position of downward dog for a number of breaths. Drawing your attention to your spine. Imagine there's an opening along the back of your spine, as if you could unbutton each vertebrae, allowing a softening and an opening, a release of that holding of the spine. And begin to move your spine in any way that feels good. Good. Come back to downward dog. From downward dog, bend the knees and release the knees to the floor. Uncurl your toes. Sit back on your heels and roll your belly over your thighs. Let the forehead rest very gently on the floor and slide your fingertips to meet your toes. Rest in child's pose and feel your breath, feel your spine. Breathe. Blessed is the one who perseveres. She will receive the crown of life that God has promised to those who love God. The crown is the natural extension of your spine. When the spine is alive and connected, the crown can shine and radiate. As you rest in child's pose for just another moment, feel that divine connection between the tailbone, sacrum, spine, and crown. From here, curl your toes. Walk your fingertips towards your knees and come into a squat. We will be coming into a balancing pose, bakasana, or the crow. You can stay right here in a squat, letting the heels come towards each other and opening the knees apart from each other. Bend forward between your thighs and take the upper arms underneath the shins, elbows pointing out, fingers spread and palms pressing into the floor. Keep the head looking up. Let the spine support the head. So the spine is very buoyant and the head is just resting gently on top of the spine. Now draw the navel in. And if you feel inclined, remember, keep the head looking up. Lift one foot off the floor, and perhaps the other, coming into balance. The shins are supported by the upper arms. Eyes look up, and we breathe. Take a breath in and exhale. Come back down, releasing the toes to the floor. Step back into downward facing dog and breathe. Lift the right foot off the floor, bend the right knee in towards the chest, and slide the right knee to the floor between your thumbs. Extend the left leg behind you into pigeon pose, Ekapadakonasana. Hands press under the shoulders, down into the mat. Spine lengthens. The natural curve of the spine lifts you up. Breathe in, breathe out. Press into the palms and come back into downward dog, stepping the right foot back to meet the left. Lift the left foot off the floor, bring the left knee into the chest, and slide the left knee between the thumbs on the floor. The left foot kind of scoots over towards the right hip. Right leg extended behind you, top of the foot resting on the floor. Press down into the fingertips or palms and lengthen the spine, lift the heart, and arch up. Release the pose, stepping the left foot back, coming into downward facing dog. Breathe in, breathe out, come into push-up or plank pose. Release the belly to the floor, release the forehead to the floor and the legs and extend them behind you. Interlock your fingers just below your lower back. Draw the chin in slightly. Extend through the legs, lift the tops of the thighs towards the backs of the hamstrings. Lift the feet off the floor, the knees and the thighs. Lift the head and chest off the floor and reach the arms back, knuckles towards the heels. Navasana or boat pose. Again, feel as if you were being lifted up. Imaginary hands holding onto your shoulders so that you can drop deeply into support. Release your boat pose, letting the legs come down, releasing the interlocked fingers, turning the head to one side, letting the cheek rest on the floor. Rest your body and shake your hips. Press onto all fours. Come back to child's pose and rest once again. Rock your hips over to the right as you slide your hands under your shoulders and roll up, extending your legs out in front of you in a seated position. Spread your legs wide in a V and flex your feet. Lengthen your spine and allow your vertebrae to fall forward as if they were little mini weights coming forward towards the front of your body as you fold into a forward bend here. Upavista Konasana, wide angle forward bend. Reach your hands for your thighs or your shins or your big toes, or the outside sides of your feet. Let there be an effortless effort as you breathe and soften into this deep opening for the hips and hamstring. Relaxed open hips give more mobility to the whole spine. Feel the spine drawing forward towards the front of your body, releasing you down. Place your hands underneath your shoulders and walk your spine back up, drawing the hips in to protect your back. Walk the feet together, extend the legs, and come into Paschimottanasana, forward bend. Reach over the thighs towards the calves or the ankles or the feet lengthen the spine. Reach down through the tailbone. Reach down through the pubic bone. Draw the pubic bone back towards the tailbone. And let there be space in the belly as the belly falls forward into seated forward bend. Breathe. I want to know Christ and the power of His resurrection and fellowship. Roll up, walking the fingers along the sides of the legs. Take the right foot and place it to the inside of the left thigh. Either using a strap around the left foot or grabbing the left foot with your hands, come forward in a semi-forward bend. Reach down through your hips, down through your sits bones, and lengthen your spine. Keep the shoulders back. This is Maha Mudra, or the Great Seal. So the intention in this pose is to keep the spine long rather than rounded in the forward bend. Breathe in, breathe out, and allow there to be a spiral flow of energy from the toes all the way up to the crown. And when the chief shepherd appears, you will receive the crown of glory that will never fade away. Being in Christ means being embodied in glory and light. Release the pose by rolling up and extend the right foot in front of you, parallel to the left foot. Now take the left foot and place it to the inside of your right thigh. Keep the right foot flexed. Stay strong in the lower body, pressing down, opening up the back of the right knee. Reach over the right leg, either with a strap or holding onto your right foot with your fingers. And draw the heart forward. Lift the throat, press the crown up. Breathing in, breathing out. Roll up and release the pose, taking the left foot straight out and just moving the legs around a little bit. Good. Now come onto your back. Draw your knees into your chest. Feel the spine on the floor. Notice what parts are connected to the floor. What parts aren't touching the floor? Notice places where you feel space between the vertebrae. And notice places where you don't feel any space, where they feel more enmeshed. Relax into this pose. Apanasana. There's nothing to do here but breathe. Draw the knees in as you inhale. Exhale, press them away. Bring the feet to the floor. And grab hold of the heels with your fingertips so the thumbs and index fingers will hook on to the backs of your heels. Roll your shoulders in and open the chest. Take a breath in as you tuck the tailbone and inhale, Lift the spine off the floor, lift the buttocks off the floor into a modified bridge, going as high as you can. Exhale, roll down from the top of your spine to the bottom. Do this about 10 times, inhaling, lifting up, buttocks come off the floor, thighs press up, hips press up, chest rolls up, exhale down, and continue. Breathing in, breathing out, lifting up, rolling down. Bring that to an end, letting the sits bones and the sacrum come back to the floor. Draw your knees into your chest again, and gently rock your body from side to side. We're now going to go into two inversions, halasana or plow, and sarvangasana or shoulder stand. If you have high blood pressure, any kind of eye challenges such as conjunctivitis or allergies, what you want to do is just stay on your back and hug your knees into your chest. You may even want to place the feet on the floor with the knees bent and just focus on your breath and your spine. Otherwise, to come into plow, you want to roll up onto your shoulders and walk your shoulder blades in. Let the buttocks come off the floor and cup your buttocks into your palms with the elbows bent. Begin by extending the legs straight up and then gradually walk your hands further down your back. As you bring the buttocks more in line with your shoulders, letting the toes come behind you on the floor. If your toes reach the floor, you can curl them under, opening up the hamstrings, lengthening the spine, drawing in energy, feeling the loop of energy around and in your body. Breathe here for about 3 to 5 breaths. Notice all the ways that we can move our spine, and notice all the ways we can be in our body by virtue of our spine. Notice all the ways you can walk with Christ. All the ways you can move through your life in this divine relationship. You can stay in plow, or you can come into sarvangasana, or shoulder stand. Bend your knees, bringing your knees into your forehead. Press down into your upper arms, and extend the legs straight up. Ultimately, the shoulders, hips, and feet will be in one straight line. But work with where you're at. Be mindful of your neck. Again, if you have any neck injuries or neck sensitivities or back issues, this is not the posture to do. Just bring your knees into your chest and relax on your back. Feel the downward movement of the flow of energy from the top of your tailbone down into your crown. Breathe. Gradually release the pose by gently bringing the knees into the forehead, sliding the arms straight out, palms to the floor by your hips, as you roll down, vertebrae by vertebrae, coming all the way down onto the floor, lower back settles into the floor, feet come into the floor. And take a breath in and breathe out here. Extend the legs all the way down. And take your arms into a wide T, palms down. Shoulders release into the floor. Bend your right knee, placing the right foot on top of the left knee. The right foot will not be pressing into the knee, just gently resting on top. Reach your left hand to the outside of your right knee and draw the right knee towards the left. Allow the head to turn to the right if that's comfortable, and keep the shoulders on the floor. Extend through the left leg. Keep the left leg energized. Energy in the body. Take a breath in and roll onto your back and extend the right leg down to meet the left. Flexing the right foot, energizing the right leg, bend the left knee. Gently place the left foot on top of the right knee. Reach the right hand for the outside of the left knee and draw the left knee over towards the right. Turn the head to the left. Soften into Supta Matsyendrasana, knee down twist. Release the pose, rolling onto your back. And one more time, draw your knees into your chest and rock your knees from side to side. Our last pose is Matsyasana, or fish pose. If you have any neck problems or eye injuries, just stay on your back and rest. Otherwise, bring your arms close to your sides and walk your hands underneath your buttocks, drawing the elbows in underneath your lower back. Flex your feet and extend through the heels. Press down into the forearms and begin to tilt your pelvis towards your thighs, so your lower back, your lumbar spine, begins to come off the floor and your cervical spine is pressing into the floor. Your thoracic spine also lifts off the floor. Press down to the arms. Actually lift the head off the floor and gently place the crown of the head back on the floor. So you're in a back bend. Feel the support of your legs and your arms. You don't want any pressure on the neck. Feel the openness of your breath and the free flow of energy along the central channel of your body. Note how the spine is centralized in your body. There's a front spine and a back spine, and we're working with both in this pose. An ego body and a divine body. Blessed are those who wash their robes, that they may have the right to the tree of life, and may go through the gates into the city. I am the root and the offspring of David, and the bright morning star. If you have come to know and accept Christ, that bright morning star resides in your heart. It flows through your spine. It is your breath, press into the arms and slide the head down. Release the pose completely. And just let the head rock from side to side. Allow the arms to come to your side and extend your legs out in front of you. Release your spine. Soften into the floor and be supported. This is relaxation pose, shavasana, surrendering our will. Let go of any need to hold or strive here. Be in the support and love of Jesus. Be in the flow of your breath and the flow of your life. Receive shavasana for a number of minutes. And when you feel complete, come back to a seated position. At this time, you can pause the CD and come back. Once you have come to an upright position after completing shavasana, bring your hands into an open, receptive position, resting the backs of your hands on your lap, and let the palms softly open. Feel your spine and feel your body, wrapped and supported around this central and essential part of who you are. Your DNA, your tree of life. In ancient Jewish mystic writings, there is much about this tree of life. In the lower part of the body, we have our roots, our sense of security and survival in the world. And then our sensuality, our creativity. As we go further up the spine, we come into our own power and how important it is for us to have our own power to be for Christ in the world. And from our own power, we move into the heart and the back of the heart, the spine supporting this so vital part of who we are. Our connection to humanity. Our connection to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. And we move further up the spine, into the upper chest and the throat, where what comes out of our mouths is the light of Christ. Moving farther up to the very tip of the spine, parallel to the brow point, we use our intuition and our wisdom, our inner knowing, to be the truth in the world, to be vibrant and light with God's love. And above all of this, we have the crown, and we have been crowned with His love and His light. I invite you now to find a comfortable position, either sitting in a chair or just sitting here in easy sitting pose, or even lying back down. I'm going to read from the Psalms. And as you receive this wonderful psalm, celebrate who you are in love, in Christ. A body, a mind, and a spirit, all intertwined. If any part of this psalm resonates with you in particular, take note of it. And when you have completed your class, perhaps take a moment to pray, to offer your heart. This is Psalm 139. It is a psalm of David. O Lord, you have searched me, and you know me. You know when I sit and when I rise. You perceive my thoughts from afar. You discern my going out and my lying down. You are familiar with all my ways. Before a word is on my tongue, you know it completely, O Lord. You hem me in. Behind and before, you have laid your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, too lofty for me to attain. Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go up to the heavens, you are there. If I make my bed in the depths, you are there. If I rise on the wings of the dawn, if I settle on the far side of the sea, even there your hand will guide me. Your right hand will hold me fast. If I say, surely the darkness will hide me, and the light become night around me, even the darkness will not be dark to you. The night will shine like the day. For darkness is as light to you. For you created my inmost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. I know that full well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in the secret place, when I was woven together in the depths of the earth, your eyes saw my unformed body. All the days ordained for me were written in your book before one of them came to be. How precious to me are your thoughts, O God. How vast is the sum of them. Were I to count them, they would outnumber the grains of sand. When I am awake, I am still with you. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my anxious thoughts. See me and lead me in the way everlasting. I invite you now to complete your practice by writing, talking to your breath, talking to your spine, listening for messages, guidance, inner wisdom. You can also draw a picture of your spine and your relationship to your spine. Receive healing and light on all levels. Be the tree of life for your own path. See God within you and all around you. Let Christ truly reside in the innermost chamber of your being. Hallelujah. Amen.